Hi, welcome to the second session on theory of computation. In this video, we'll discuss about the course content that we will be covering during this course. As I have said in the last class, we are going to deal only about the membership problem of formal languages. So for recognizing each formal language, we will implement the membership problem in terms of computational model. So the course objectives are like this. The first objective says that this course will make you understand different computational models. That means that we have different membership functions that will recognize different formal languages, different types of formal languages, and we will be able to understand these computational models. And next to comprehend the properties of computational model. So each formal language or each type of formal language has a specific property that will distinguish itself from the other type. So these properties we will get to know about. And at the end of the course, okay, you will be able to develop the computational model to recognize regular languages or context-free languages. So regular language and context-free languages are different types of formal languages. And we will be able to develop the membership problem in terms of computational models. The next course outcome is to establish the equivalence among computational models, which is of equivalent computational capacity. This is more like we are able to develop more than one computational model to solve or to find the membership problem of this same formal language. Okay, so to understand this, imagine like this. Suppose if I give a problem to two different people and ask you to solve by yourself, most probably the solution that you develop independently will be different. But the objective of the solution is the same. Both are solving the same problem. So both are equivalent in nature, but they are actually two different solutions. Okay, so it is very similar to this. Okay, we are trying to establish the equivalence among the computational models which does the same job. And the third course outcome is we should be able to recall the procedures involved in the construction of computational models. These are standard procedures that we will discuss in the course. Okay, so from the examination point of view, this first outcome can be asked in the level of synthesis or application. And in the second outcome will be either analysis or comprehension. And the third outcome will be in knowledge level or comprehension level in the Bloom's taxonomy. In the first unit, we will cover the first type of computational model, which is the finite automata. So in finite automata, we will deal with three different machines: deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata, and one variant of non-deterministic finite automata, which includes epsilon transition as well. All these three models compute the same membership problem. So we will have proving techniques to establish the equivalence between these three computational models. And in the second unit, we will cover the regular expressions and regular languages. These are the formal language being recognized by the finite automata. Or I can say the finite automata is actually computing the membership problem of the formal language named the regular language. So we will have the algebraic laws governing it, given a language, whether to prove whether it is really a regular language or not, its properties, all those things we will cover in the second unit. And in third unit, we will see the next type of computational model, which is the deterministic pushdown automata. We have two variants in this one, and both are equivalent, and we will establish its equivalence as well. And the language being recognized by the pushdown automata is called the context-free languages. And these languages are governed by the grammar, context-free grammar. And we will study all the properties, and given any language, whether the language is context-free or not, this we will be able to decide. All these things we will deal it in third unit. And in fourth unit, we will learn about the third computational model, which is the Turing machine. These Turing machines are the highest computational capacity that we know till now. That is, our modern computers are based on the theoretical model of the Turing machine. That means that if the Turing machine is unable to solve a problem, that means that with the modern computer that we have today, I will not be able to solve the problem. So, the language being recognized by Turing machine, how to develop solution using a Turing machine, all these things we will deal in fourth unit. And in fifth unit, it is an important chapter. Remember in the last lecture I said we have large set of functions for which we do not have any algorithm. So all those problems are dealt in fifth unit, undecidable problems and intractable problems. All these are dealt in fifth unit. And the classes P and NP, the class of problems which have polynomial time solutions, and the class of problems which do not have polynomial time deterministic solution, but we can design non-deterministic polynomial time solution. Since the solution is non-deterministic, for time being we will not be able to implement this solution with our modern computers. And there are lot more problems which we can establish the equivalence and say such problems do not have solutions. Okay, all these things we will deal in fifth unit. And the learning resources include the introduction to automata theory, languages and computations by Hopcroft, Motwani and Ullman. This is your textbook, and the textbook includes all the five chapters, all the five units. Reference, in addition to that, you can refer to the reference books, Automata and Computability by Dexter Posen, Introduction to Languages and the Theory of Computation by John Martin, and Introduction to Formal Languages and Automata by Peter Lenz. And one more reference book, Introduction to Formal Languages, Automata Theory and Computation by Kamala Kethivasan and Rama. This book personally I feel is good for Turing machines, and there are lots of problem being solved for finite automata and the context-free languages. The e-references, I have given two NPTEL courses, and one from the Stanford University by Ullman, the author of our textbook. So here we can get the slides of the textbook in PDF and PPT, I think so. And the scheme of evaluation is as usual. You will have 60% of the marks being contributed by the end semester exam, which is 3-hour close book written exam. And the internal marks, you have 40%, which is 40 marks in absolute. And in that, 75% of your internal marks comes from 3 continuous assessment tests. Each test is for 90 minutes, and each test is closed book written exam. And the 75% of internal marks actually contribute to 30 marks in absolute. And we will have 3 assignment which we will evaluate for 5 marks, and we will have tutorials or objective. This can be either scheduled or it can be surprised, but what I have thought is, since this is lockdown period, we will have an objective type test with at the end of every video lecture, and each of this test will be counted for internal assessment. So please take it seriously to do all the three components of your internal assessment. And in the next lecture, we will have a big picture of the theory of computation, and then we will go to the fundamentals necessary to understand the principles that we will be learning in theory of computation, and then we will actually get into the course. Thank you so much for watching the video.